As I said also, I'm also the chair of the Black Starline Cooperative Credit Union. Now, this is our 10th anniversary. We were formed in 2009 by the Rastafari Council of Ghana. And we're celebrating our 10th anniversary this year. Now, the Black Starline Credit Union was formed on the opinions and philosophies of Marcus Mosiah Garvey, that we have the power within our community to uplift ourselves. We have the wisdom to uplift ourselves. All it takes is discipline and unity. And so the Black Starline Credit Union is a living legacy of the Honorable Marcus Mosiah Garvey in real action, in doing form. We are celebrating 10 years of giving loans to our members, giving very attractive interest rates. We get better interest rates here than you get out there. So I'm advising all of you to look at our table over there. I have my colleagues, they can wave their hands. Jemima, Na, and Pius. And please visit the table. They have application forms. You can be a member even from outside. Actually, 60% of our members live in the US, the UK, Canada, Jamaica, because Marcus Garvey is not only for Ghana. Marcus Garvey is black family worldwide. Am I right?
Right. Sure.
So when we talk about upliftment, we talk about putting your money where your mouth is. You can't be building when your money is in the very people's hands that don't think about you. The very people's hands that will fund a company like Monsanto. The very people that will fund all sorts of programs, and you know the kind of programs from where you're coming from. So your money must be where your mouth is, and you must save with some institution that gives you power. If you want to buy land in future, you want to come home, build a house, start saving now. You can send us payments through Wave. Wave is an application you can put on your phone. So whether you live in Atlanta, Chicago, or Toronto, you can send us money on your phone, and you can check your account online. So I encourage all of you to buy shares. Buy shares in the Black Star Line. I keep telling my colleagues that the Black Star Line is very uniquely positioned because we have the appeal that no other big bank has. Barclays Bank cannot attract your money if you're serious about Africa. Neither can Standard Chartered or Stanbic and all those banks. So the market that we're looking at is a multi-trillion dollar market because we have the consuming power in the West. When you go to the malls, it's our brothers and sisters that have the shopping bags. Am I lying?
Yeah.
We have the buying power. So the power of black people all over the world, from Papua New Guinea to Canada, Jamaica, there are black people in India and so on and so forth. That is the power, that is the vision of where eventually we want to get to. But we started from Ghana, we're celebrating 10 years. This is the year of the return. Ironically, this is the 400th year of the anniversary of the first boats that came here for the African Holocaust. So it's a very ironic time, and the tides are changing. Like I said, the fact that you found yourself to come back here is a celebration in your own personal life, and you must continue that by building. So join the Black Star Line, make sure you visit our table, buy a share or two, and when you go back, be an ambassador for us, tell your family, tell your friends. Nobody else is going to build our institutions unless we do. So without speaking too long, I'd like to thank you here, and long live the Black Star Line, long live Food Summit Ghana, long live Africa.
We really appreciate the information, because we have to control our economics and we have to cut those big banks and lose those multinational corporations.
That's right.
He mentioned Monsanto, it was bought by Bayer, and they paid $84 billion, so they stole a lot of money from people through all this scientific concoction. Okay, we won.